It's the visionaries who create action and who create results in the world and who make and who invent things and who become the leaders that each of you are. How many of you know who this guy is? Colonel Sanders. Colonel Sanders was a military retiree at the age of 65, I believe. And at the age of 65, he was finding that his welfare checks just weren't cutting it. He wasn't making enough money to pay his bills. And all that he had to his name was his best fried chicken recipe, passed down from his mom. And so he decided that he was going to go out and he was going to sell this chicken recipe to different restaurants and have them just pay him when someone orders it and have it be like a commission type thing where they were going to sell he was going to sell the recipe. And so he went out, and time after time again, the only thing he owns at this point is his sports wagon. You know, the long cars with the big trunk in the back, that's all he owned. And so he was sleeping in it while he was driving throughout the country trying to get people to buy this chicken recipe. He went time after time again to different restaurants, asking them to sell, you know, giving out samples, and he lived off of the leftovers from the samples that he had made for people in the restaurant. 1,007 times he was turned down. 1,007 before he received his first yes. And that yes was what became Kentucky Fried Chicken. Had he have given up after 100, 200, 300, 900 times, none of you would have had a piece of Kentucky Fried Chicken. And so I think you understand my point, how powerful it is to consistently persist, to consistently, whether all the signs are against us, to continue moving in the right direction. How many of you ever heard of Chicken Soup for the Soul? Anybody read a copy? Awesome. Mark Victor Hansen and Jack Canfield wrote that book, 101 Stories, and they went to New York to try and shop a publisher. And as they were walking through to the different publishers and pitching them on their stories, they went to 110 publishers, and they all turned him down. Both of them, they turned both of them down. Said, no, nobody likes reading short stories, nobody likes this, and so we're not publishing it. They were out of luck. And so the question that they asked themselves was, who's more powerful than a publisher themselves? And the answer was, a publisher's wife. And so they happened to have a connection to one of the publishers they had visited, their wives, and they brought the stories, and it's what became Chicken Soup for the Soul, because that night, the wife was reading the manuscript with her husband laying next to him, and every story, time after time again, she would hit him and say, hey, look at this. Hey, look at this. Hey, read this. So by the end of the night, he was finally saying, look, let me sleep. I'm going to publish the dang thing. Right? It's that kind of persistence. It's thinking outside the box. It's taking things to the next level and really persisting beyond that which you believe is possible, that you're going to create results. I'd like you to stand in a place of power, grounded in your possibility, grounded in your vision for the future, in what's available for you, in taking on this vision. Stand in what you can create in this world, in what you've already created, in who you've contributed to, and in who you've yet to contribute to. In who you've loved and in who's loved you. Stand in a place of power with all that you're grateful for. And from that place, I'd like you to move forward to a place where you've accomplished your vision. Step into the place where you are now standing. Maybe it's 5 years from now, maybe it's 3 years from now, maybe it's 10 years from now. Stand in that place where you've accomplished your goal. To become an engineer. To become a doctor. To be a successful entrepreneur. How does it feel to be in this place? When you've stood tall, you've taken action, and you've been of service in the world. Who's with you in this place? Where are you living? Where are you working? Or maybe where are you attending school? At MIT? At Harvard? At UCLA? In all of your accomplishment, stand tall knowing that you can do anything. That you have all that you need and more inside you now. That you just being you is more than enough in this world. And that the more love you give, the more love you'll receive. Stand in this place of accomplishment. In this place of success. Of fulfillment. Of realizing your dreams. Knowing that somewhere along this journey, you had to say, I am the voice. I'm the only voice that matters. It's my voice. That you decided to lead instead of follow. That you decided to defy the odds and set new standards. Stepped up beyond anything anyone believed in, because you believed in yourself. Because you were of creation in this world. You were a force for good. A force of transformation. Welcome to this place. And as you come back now, I want you to reflect on the journey that you've had in getting to this place. On what it took to get here. And as you return to us in this room, give yourselves a round of applause for taking that journey.